In honor of the new Han Solo movie that's coming out, I decided to make Han Solo's classic blaster, the DL-44. So I went ahead and I made a pattern of a Mauser. Well, I made this one earlier. The gun that Han Solo's blaster is based off of. And so, as you can see, like the actual prop, the barrel is shorter and much wider than the actual one. So what I need to do now is just to cut it out. The handle needs to be 3 layers of foam thick, but as you can see, I've only got 2 layers of foam here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put the dash where the hand grip it ends and cut it off there. So now you might be saying, well, you just cut off the trigger guard because, well, you messed it up. And yes, I did mess it up. And yes, I did cut it off because I messed it up. But this also gives me the opportunity to make the trigger guard thinner without having to take my knife and cut it at an angle to get the trigger guard thinner. So maybe in the future, next time I make one of these, I will just cut like that instead of having to fight the inside. I don't really like that the hammer on this foam Mauser is the same thickness as the gun. So I think I'm going to draw a line and cut that out.
I have completed the flash suppressor for the DL-44. All that's left to do is to put on the cone piece. I'm going to make that out of craft foam, also along with the detailing that goes on the side of the DL-44. That will be done in craft foam, like I said. For the grill piece on the front, I have this piece of ribbed piping that I've cut and that I will glue on to the front, like so. For the scope, I have this piece of PVC pipe. It has a sort of nozzle on the end. I just need to cut.
So as I mentioned before, here is the nozzle for the flash suppressor. And here's that. The glue is currently setting up on this one. So now what I'm going to do is set the glue for this part of the blaster. And once this dries, I will then glue it into here. So here's the scope setup. As you can see, it's a little bit wiggly when I put the scope, just sort of balanced it on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue in these sort of like little spacers, and they'll fit in back here. And here is the scope. This is going to be, there's going to be another one of these, and that will fit onto there, and it'll end up being glued tightly, and I think it'll work. Not the most detailed Han Solo blaster in the world, not the most accurate either, but it's mine, and I view it more as a stunt blaster than a you know, hero prop. So that's my philosophy. So yeah, there we go. Now it's plasti dip it and paint it. The black coat is now dried. Now I'm going to mask off this area, do the brown for the hand grip and silver for the flash suppressor, and then I'll detail that. There it is. There is my DL-44 heavy blaster pistol. Now, so I painted it. There's the mystery disc. It was done with a plasti dip. Then I gave it a glossy black coat. And then I went back over and dry brushed the silver and the brass, as you can see here on the ends of the scope. Put in, dry brush the black and the brown onto the silvery scope, and sort of gave that a uneven, sort of more wooden, one could call it, finish. I am very pleased with how this turned out.